Then, this is in short, I want to focus you regarding the host immune mechanism. It is there. So the host have their own immune systems, defense mechanisms are there, and using their different soldiers, weapons, like the cells and organs of immune systems, they are 24 hours, they are ready to fight the infection. But irrespective of this, the humans, they will get suffered from various types of the infections. And the cause, multiple cause it is there, but very important cause is the loss of the immunity or some defects that are developed in their immunity. And when such defects were developed in the immunity, the infections, they come up. Okay. And mostly there are different causative agents are there, but the more chances they are that of the bacterial infections are there, gram-positive bacteria and gram-negative bacteria. I'm not going to enter in discuss about the differences between the gram-positive and that of the gram-negative that is shown in this chart, but everyone is a microbiologist, so they know the basic differences between the gram-positive bacteria and that of the gram-negative bacteria. Gram-negative bacteria, they are more pathogenic as compared to the gram-positive bacteria, because the gram-negative bacteria, they are expressing n number of the virulent factors. Okay, they are expressing different types of the virulent factors, antigens, which are either protein in nature, they are lipoproteins in nature, they are lipopolysaccharide in nature. Along with that, they are producing various types of the toxins, like the exotoxin, endotoxin, enterotoxin. Okay, so that's why the strength of gram-negative bacteria towards the pathogenicity is more as compared to that of the gram-positive bacteria. It is there. Few infections and the diseases, they are listed here. Now we are coming towards the infections of the gram-negative bacteria. They stain with the secondary dye, that is your in gram staining methods, and they, what you observe them under the microscope, that is the gram negative pink color, that is the cells that you observe. Mostly the gram negative bacteria, mostly they are in the coccobacillary form, but few are the cocci are there. Okay, like the Neisseria, diplococci are there, Neisseria meningitidis, Neisseria gonorrhea, which is responsible to cause meningitis and gonorrhea. And so many list it is there, opportunistic pathogens, which is a very common, that is a Escherichia coli are there, which is a normal inherent of our gastrointestinal tract. But in the, what you can say, that is the unfavorable body conditions, now they will become opportunistic and cause infections. And very common infection of Escherichia coli, they are for the dysentery, diarrhea, and urinary tract infections are there. Klebsiella is also very well known. Klebsiella pneumoniae causes pneumonia, urinary tract infection, septicemia. Then Shigella is there, Salmonella, Salmonella typhi, Salmonella paratyphi A, Salmonella paratyphi B, which is causing enteric fever. We call it as an typhoid. Cholera, it is caused by Vibrio cholerae, and so many other plague is there, meningitis, whooping cough, brucellosis, tuberculosis. So n number of list it is there, and all of them, they these such types of the diseases, they are caused by the potential gram negative bacteria are there. Based on their systemic invasions, they are classified as the bacteria pathogenics, which are causing respiratory infection, upper respiratory tract, lower respiratory tract, gastrointestinal tract. Okay, then they are responsible to cause urinary infection. Then they are responsible to cause infections to the central nervous system, circulatory systems, etc. Now coming towards the Salmonella and the typhoid infection. So in 1885, first time it was observed by the Daniel Salmon, that he discovered this Salmonella from the intestine of the pig, and he named it as an Salmonella coliraceus. Then in 1980, Eberith he first time identified and discovered the typhoid bacillus from the spleen sections and the mesenteric lymph node from the patient who died because of the typhoid. And then he say he observed that these are the typhoid bacilli which is responsible to cause the typhoid. And later on, the pathogenicity of this typhoid bacillus, that is proved by the Robert Koch, because they have postulated Koch postulates, and based on Koch postulates, they confirmed the related findings and succeeded in cultivating the bacterium in 1881. Serodiagnosis of this typhoid was thus made possible in 1896. Then Wright first time he prepared the heat killed vaccine from Salmonella typhi in 1896. All of you know about the typhoid Mary. She was a carrier, okay? And the best known carrier, she was a best known carrier, Mary Mellon, and she was the cook in the Oyster Bay, New York, and who is known to have infected 53 people, and five of whom they died. The latter returned with the false name, okay, but detained and quarantined after another typhoid outbreak. She was responsible for that, and she died of pneumonia after 26 years in the quarantine. So the carriers also, they are very important related to the communicable disease like the typhoid. Now let us see about the morphology of this causative agent of typhoid. The typhoid, it is caused by gram negative rod shaped bacteria which are Salmonella, belonging to the family Enterobacteriaceae. The Enterobacteriaceae means they are inhabitant of the gastrointestinal tract. It is there. The two species, they are there of Salmonella, Salmonella enterica and Salmonella bongori. Salmonella enterica is a type species, and which is further divided into the six subspecies, that is including near about 2600 serotypes. So serotyping has been carried out based on the different subgroups of the two important antigen. One, it is a somatic O antigen, and another one, it is a flagellar H antigen is there. The name Salmonella, it is given as it is described, discovered by the Daniel Salmon, okay, who was the American veterinary surgeon. It is there. They are non-spore forming organisms, Salmonella, and they are motile. They are highly motile. Why they are said highly motile? Because they are carrying peritrichous flagella. If you see this particular diagram here, you can see that the all around the cell, the flagella, it is there. So the peritrichous flagella, it is a very important tool for the locomotions, and because of that, they can rapidly migrate and colonize in the gastrointestinal tract. It is there. Based on their nutritional ability, the Salmonella, they are the chemotrophic organisms are there. Chemotrophs means they are obtaining their energy from oxidation and reduction reaction using the organic sources. Then they are also facultative anaerobic in nature, means they are capable of generating the ATP, because energy it is required to drive them. Okay, so the driving force behind all this pathogenicity, it is an energy. So how the Salmonella produce the energy? ATP, it is generated with oxygen when it is available, but when oxygen is not available, it is generated using other electron acceptor or by the process of fermentations, and that's why they are the facultative anaerobic in nature. The infectious disease which is caused by them, it is called as an typhoid, okay, which is a infectious disease, that is a feverish disease caused by this bacterium Salmonella enterica, Servover typhi, and is less commonly by Salmonella paratyphi A and paratyphi B. This is an communicable disease. It is there. It is rapidly spread in the community with different sources are there, and it is developed in man only, okay, that is include both typhoid fevers caused by typhi and paratyphi. The infection, it is a acute generalized infection of reticuloendothelial system. Then main important target for Salmonella, it is the intestinal lymphoid tissues and the gallbladder. It is there. this infection is always comes from the other human. Okay, that's why it is called as a communicable disease. It is there, so it comes from the other human, either it is an ill person or a healthy carrier of that particular bacterium. It is there. This bacterium, it is passed into the water and the food, okay, and in refrigeration conditions also they can remain, and that's why the use of contaminated water, use of contaminated food and use of refrigerated food, they are also high risk factor in case of the spread of such types of the communicable disease, that is the typhoid. Epidemiology, that is World Health Organization's, according to them, the epidemics of this typhoid, it was globally some 16 million cases were occur annually, resulting in more than 600,000 death. Out of that, 62% global cases occurs only in the Asia, and of which 7 million they occurs in the Southeast Asia. It is there in India, especially the Sangli, that is in the Maharashtra. It is highlighted for the world largest outbreak of the typhoid during December 1975 to February 1976. The disease is endemic in India, but the fatality is low. That is 1 to 2% it is there. Means it is an controllable disease. We can control the outbreak of this disease by taking the proper major health precautions and knowledging the educating the people regarding the health and the hygiene. It is there. Now moving towards the virulent factors of the Salmonella. The virulent factors of the Salmonella, they are mostly antigens. Two types of the antigens are there. O antigens and the H antigens are there. O, they are called as in somatic antigens. H, it is a flagellar antigen is there. Somatic antigen, it is a polysaccharide in nature, and flagellar antigen, it is a proteinaceous in nature. It is there. The antibody for the O antigens, they form rapidly, rapid and early. And for H, they are rapid, but they sustain. But the level that will get immediately fall down in case of O antigen, and they persist for longer in case of the H antigen. These factors, they are important, that when you are taking the blood sample of the patient in the first week, second week and third week, and when you are processing for serological diagnosis, then based on the serological diagnosis, you are able to identify the nature of the diseases there. When the agglutination, it is carried out, the characteristic agglutination that is observed for O antigen, it is a granular clumps, and for H, it is a cottony fluffy precipitate. It is there. The specific tubes also they are used, that I am going to discuss with you in Vidal test. The O antigens, they are heat labile and resistant to alcohol, while H, they are heat labile and sensitive to the alcohol. It is there. Based on immunogenicity, O antigens, they are less immunogenic. Antibodies, they are produced with low titer. And for H antigen, they are highly immunogenic, and antibodies, they are produced with the high titer. It is there. Now, besides that, it was also observed that in serological, during serological diagnosis, it was observed that the patient, they are showing the symptoms of the typhoid, but they are not showing agglutination with the H antigens or O antigen. Mainly, when the patient serum is not showing agglutination with the O antigen, okay, it was observed that not only it is a typhoid negative test, but in this case, there is a possibility of infection of the patient with a typical Salmonella, which are carrying the third virulence factors with them, and which is called as an VI antigen. It is an envelope antigen. It is there, which is coating the cell wall of the Salmonella. It is a lipopolysaccharide in nature. And this was invented by the Felix and described as an antigen related to the virulence of the Salmonella. It is a heat labile destroyed by acid and alkali. but resistant to alcohol and formaldehyde. So such bacteria, such salmonella, which are carrying virulence antigens with them, even if they remain for a short period of the time in the body, they are responsible to spread the disease rapidly. Okay, and they are more virulent, but they fail to agglutinate with the O antiserum in the Vidal test. It can be identified by another method, that is the phage typing method. It is used to identify the VI antigens. So why they are more virulent? Because the polysaccharides that are produced by these VI antigens, they are responsible to inhibit phagocytosis. Okay, they are resisting to complement activation and bacterial disease. Means these are the natural defense mechanisms are there, but the release of these VI polysaccharides, virulent polysaccharides, they inhibit the phagocytosis. So macrophages, they cannot stop the invasion of the salmonella. They resist the complement fixation. So the complement proteins, they are also found to be failure in resisting the entry, and as well as the bacteria, they will not lyse by cytotoxicity. Hence, they will get the opportunity, the salmonella will get the opportunity to migrate and colonize in the body. Okay, so likewise, related to the multiple drug resistance, these virulence factors of the salmonella, the genes which are responsible for these virulence factors, they are organized on the special islands which are called as in pathogenicity islands, which are present on the genome of this salmonella. So the type 3 secretion systems, that is the T3SS proteins, they are the components of these pathogenicity islands, and these proteins, they are encoded by the two salmonella pathogenicity island. One, it is a SPI1 protein, which contains the invasion genes, and these invasion genes, they are responsible, they help the salmonella to invade the body. Okay, then SPI2 genes, they are responsible for intracellular pathogenicity, that they are responsible for the launching systemic infection. But after all, the infectivity, understanding the mechanism by which salmonella invade the host defense systems and establish the pathogenesis, it is important for proper disease management. So ultimately, who will win the race, that will depend upon the power of immunity as well as the power of the pathogenicity. Whoever will win, that is responsible, either the destroying the pathogens